I'm sure you all know, Quick Trip is coming. It is positive that they will be here. I'm not gonna say who my contact is because he doesn't want us to be out there because we do have the naysayers that want to hound them to death. And what they look at is they will be closing on all the property. They bought the Northern Hotel, America's Best. They bought the Johnson's house and they bought the Harris's house. So they actually bought all the way from the stoplight to the 40 exit ramp. They have plenty of room to build. The Generation 3 Quick Trip is what they're gonna build.
Did you mean the northern motel or the southern?
Southern, did I say northern, sorry. They bought the Southern, America's Best, all the way to the I-40 exit. They plan to build the Generation 3 Quick Trip, which is exactly like Muskogee's. I don't know if you've been to Muskogee's, it's nonstop busy, has a really nice truck stop for them to go to, showers, the whole nine yards. My contact has told me that Quick Trip moves very quickly once they close on property, that they don't like it to sit there. So he is estimating about 6 months that they will be up and running.
Wow.
This is paramount for Henrietta. Nothing new has come to Henrietta that could draw things off the highway like a truck stop can. They did studies. There's about 50,000 people that cross that intersection every day. We're not even getting a tenth of that pulled in. Our tax base in Henrietta, and this is what makes Henrietta function, is tax base. Buying local is very important because our local taxes is 4%. We don't get ad valorem. We don't get property taxes. We only get city sales tax to function in the city. With that being said, it is around 200,000 is where we stay. And it's been down this entire year, but 2 months. And when you know, we get all the grief of, when are you gonna overlay roads? One block to overlay is about $60,000. When you have water pipes busting every day, when you have a freeze, that you have 3 10-inch lines that busted in a week, you have crews out all night long for multiple days at a time, paving a street is the least of our worries at this moment. I think your water running in your house is probably more important, water running in your business, and keeping the infrastructure up, because we won't recruit any businesses if we don't have an infrastructure. We do have the 1 million gallon tank up and running. We have no issues with it. Everything's been going good. We did have an issue at the water plant. Luckily, we had that tower, so none of y'all ever even knew that we had an issue running. If we would have just had the one tower, we would have been out of water probably Friday night at 10 o'clock, till who knows when, till they get the problem fixed. Because there's only one company that comes and works on the mechanics of the water plant, and you have to wait on them because they jeopardize what you can and can't do. So you can't get real hateful with them, and you can't do anything because you have to wait on them to get there, and they know they're the only game in town. So you just have to deal with it. As far as Quick Trip goes, I've got lots of grief on my Facebook about it because they're saying, oh, well, you offered them money to come. They were offered a deal with HEDA. This is not anything out of the ordinary. This is how every economic development in the state of Oklahoma is working. I go to mayor conference after mayor conference trying to learn how to grow our city, because staying here and doing nothing, we're going to die as a community. If we do not grow, it's going to be status quo. Nothing's going to change forever here. And so, yes, I'm going to make people mad, but I have kids and grandkids that live here, and I want to see them stay here. I don't want them all to move off to find better, bigger and better jobs, better places to stay. Why can't we make this the bigger, better job? Why can't we make Henrietta what it should be? We're at I-40 and 75. We have all the numbers. Now let's get the growth. Yes, that puts our economic development having to help people come. But in the long run, what's $600,000 over 4 years to a Quick Trip? Even they're telling us they could probably pay it back in two. And it's not even a done deal. They never even gave us that contract. They never even came back with it. So we don't even know if they're going to do that, because that was to buy the Northern Hotel. So now that they didn't do that, we don't even know if they're going to come back to us for money. But that came up today. That was in the paper today. But I don't foresee anything that we do with Quick Trip being a problem. They are estimating they would put anywhere from $40,000 to $80,000 in our tax base per month. by pulling people off the highway. I keep hearing everybody say it's going to shut down Main Street. If I go to Jiffy Mart, I go to Vicks, I go to Lowe's, I go to Jiffy Mart. That's the three convenience stores I typically go to because they're on the route of where I'm going. If you live on the west end of Maine, you go to Haley's, you go to Rockies, you go to whatever you're going to down there. Are you really going to change that daily routine and go all the way to the other end of Main Street to go to Quick Trip?
No.
Probably not. When it's brand new, you might go see what it's like, just like Shoney's. Was Shoney's not booming every single day? You had to wait for a spot to sit. It hurt some of the small restaurants for about 30 days. Now they have no problem. It's back to the same as it was because the new has worn off. But we're still pulling those highway dollars in because we have a new restaurant. It'll be the same thing with Quick Trip. They do have new things. Maybe it'll make some people improve what they have here to try to compete with them. We get lax in what we do, and it takes everybody working as a team to make things move forward. You know, we've had lots of people try to come to the city. I have multiple things working right now. I can't tell you what they are because every time I tell, we get backlash. The clinic that's going up on the industrial park, Eastern Oklahoma Family Clinic, they had the one town crier stop them from getting federal funds. Literally stop them from getting it. So then we didn't say anything. We just acted like it was done and pretended that they never got the money. Whereas Donna Dyer kept fighting to get it, and we finally got it approved. So we didn't do anything until we announced that it was done because that's how it worked. I have four businesses that plan to locate Henrietta in the next 9 months. I can't tell you any of that because as soon as I tell you, then it runs like wildfire and then they get backlash of what they're going to do. The one owner tells me all the time, just keep it between us. Don't say a word because as soon as you do, so that person's going to tell the next person. And it happens because we hear it all the time. There's lots of rumors of what's coming to Henrietta. There are things coming, I can tell you that. And I do not see anything bad coming in Henrietta, no matter what we do. I see growth. I think we have a really good council right now. I think we have the interim city manager doing a great job. I don't know if you all know Donna White, but she's a very detailed person. She could tell me to the penny of what's in every single account if I called her every 30 minutes all day long. That's just what she does. She is a detailed person, and she stays on top of that. Ron Casey, our public works director, is out making sure all the jobs that we have going are being done as they should be done, making sure the guys are doing what they should be doing. And I have seen more improvements in the last 2 or 3 years in this town than I've seen in my life, and I've been here my whole life. The hospital authority, since there's a couple of them here, we voted with some different issues on Monday night to remodel the emergency room. And so that's going to be a big deal for Henrietta as well, because it's you've all been there. If you live here, you've all been there. And you know, there's no flow to that. There's no privacy to that. When you go out there, everybody knows your business from the time you walk in the door till the time you leave. You know, A bed's got the flu, B bed's got who knows what, they're still working on that. Lifelight's coming to get Joe Blow over here because he fell and hit his head. But that's how it works. So Henrietta is moving forward. Some people would rather stay in the past, I hear all the time, but that's the way we've always done it. Well, just because you've always done it doesn't mean that it's correct. It doesn't mean that it will fix the future. What I'm looking at is longevity of Henrietta and where we can be in 10 years and how this city can prosper from what we're going to do now and how it's going to be better when we get there. I don't know how long I'll be on the council. I know I still have 3 years ahead of me. But, you know, every 2 years is an election. All we can do is what we can do with who's on there. Right now, the council is all about progression. And it works really well for where we're headed as far as Henrietta as a whole. Because I get way more compliments of what's happening than the negativity of what they don't like. Y'all have any questions about what we have going?
How many employees will Quick Trip approximately?
They told us about 60 when they did the presentation. But it'll just depend on what all they're doing. He said anywhere from 40 to 70 is typical, but he's assuming 60 for Henrietta. And they start at a significant wage. I think the tellers and stalkers were gonna be about $12 an hour, and then it went up from there.
Well, there was nobody minimum wage.
Nobody.
In fact, I think last year there was a big scuttle about public school teachers, because it came out that there are a number of Quick Trip employees that make more than teachers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
Have you seen an increase in tax dollars incoming yet with just Shelby's online? No, it's early.
I know where Shoney's has been because Doug and Nancy have told me where they have been. But because of the head of contract, we haven't really pulled that. We have been up, but we also had that race. But you realize we're 2 months behind.
Yes.
So when I tell you what our tax base was, that's 2 months old, because that's how the tax commission works. And so we have seen a little bit of an increase. I think it was around $6,000 this time. And that could be part of that. It could be buying local, you know, because that would have been November.
Yeah.
And there was lots of sales in town and different things. But I do think Shoney's will make a significant difference. I do know that their grand opening is one of the biggest Shoney's has ever had. Doug and Nancy help Henrietta in any way, shape they can. They're always willing to help. If we have a city event going on, she's calling me first thing going, where can I take bottled water? What snacks do you want? Anything that we have going, they're always on top of it. I support local. I try to buy local every time I can. There's some things you just can't buy local and you have to go out of town to get them. I see people at Homeland buying groceries and I always tell them thanks for buying local because, you know, our grocery store is expensive. And I get it. There's some people that can't afford to always buy things there because it is high. I get that all the time too. Why don't we have another grocery store? I can only invite who's come. I can't force them to be here. Why aren't you doing more for kids? Well, the city can't run a movie theater. But if you want to bring one, we're happy to help you. And anything that we could get to come to Henrietta that's going to improve quality of life is just one more thing. We're working hand in hand with the school now. There's a good relationship with the school. We don't have any conflict like there was in the past. We work with them. We try to help them. I know Public Works is always doing anything they can do to help them with any problems they have at the school. We gave them the street so they could close it because the kindergarten, they were worried about the traffic. And we don't have any issues with that. The school is improving, and so the city improving will just be a win-win. I hear people say all the time, why do we not have new houses? That comes with jobs. You bring businesses in, people follow. They're not going to come buy a house and hope for a business because they know how small town politics works. And that's how it used to work. But I'm not one of those people. So if I step on your toes because I'm making Henrietta better, I'm sorry that I stepped on your toes, but I'm going to keep stepping on them because we're going to improve and we're going to move forward. And that's my goal as the mayor, and that's my job. I hear all the time, you pretend to be the city manager. No, actually, I'm being the mayor. The mayor's job is to make sure that anything that I'm voting on is completed and done accurately. So if you've seen our agendas, you know that 90% of everything that goes through the city is voted on by the council. So if I'm going to put my name on it, and I'm going to sign off on the bottom of it, by golly, I'm going to go look at it and make sure it's done to the best of the ability they can do it. Or I'm not signing it. That's just not who I am. It's either give 125% or nothing. Because I can't do it any other way. So if that's not good enough for you, I can tell you when you can sign up for the next election.
Jennifer, to make a point, you were talking about the medical clinic. And it's my understanding it was about a $1 million grant.
Yes.
And when she says they have to keep things under wrap, I believe they discovered that they would have received it a year before, but there's an individual that I will not say his name, but I probably don't have to, had written over 400 emails to them trying to deter them from that. I don't understand a rhyme or reason or even an incentive.
And he did deter them. We just had to help Donna come up with letters of other cities that had used industrial sites. to build the same exact thing in other states. And once they found out that this has happened time and time again, then the federal funds were granted to her, but it did take well over a year and a half past the date she thought it was gonna be. She really had given up, but then it got granted. But that happens over and over. Shoney's, they had a nightmare getting started. They were called into the state every week. Ron can attest to that, because we had Jody down there with code trying to work it out. They had every state inspector there every other week, looking at everything they were doing, checking licenses on everybody there. They've already been called into the tax commission, and they've already been called into the labor board. So, you know, it's really hard when all of that gets out to get small businesses that want to come here and want to put up with that nightmare. That's time consuming and ridiculous.
Do they know? I mean, is there any way to verify?
Oh, they know.
Call?
They know, and at the town hall meeting last night, he admitted it.
Well, in addition to that, you also have, I mean, Quick Trip can locate anywhere they want.
Absolutely.
And they can get the towns in the state are bending over backwards to encourage them to come to your city, and then we have this individual who's discouraging it. Plus, those towns are also providing incentives for not just Quick Trip, but other businesses in town. So the idea of an incentive in some way to entice a business into your community is just the normal way of doing business.
It's very normal. That's what the economic development groups were even created for.
Yes.
There would be no reason to have an economic development if you weren't going to do anything. It's not just a savings account. It is to promote business in your city for economic growth.
You saw that with all the Amazon bids.
Yes.
Every city offered millions and millions of dollars because they knew what would come with it.
Yeah,
if they could get Amazon to come to their city. I mean, geez, that's just so
well, in Quick Trip, we have not done anything. The council has not approved. HEDA has not approved anything. We talked to them. HEDA talked to them. But they haven't brought anything back to us at all because they don't even know if they're going to ask us for help. They just want to throw it out there and see. The site locator and myself, Ron Casey, and a couple others have been diligently working on this. You have no idea what all it has taken to get to where we are today. We fought ODOT like nobody's business. Up until last week, we were still fighting ODOT because they wanted to auction off the right-of-way. Weren't even gonna give Quick Trip the benefit to buy it. Nope, can't do it, we gotta auction it off. All because of that one person hounding them to death, telling them, you better dot every I and cross every T, because I'm watching everything you're doing. So we found the loophole. They can sell it to the adjacent owner. Well, of course, Quick Trip's going to be the adjacent owner. So they can sell it to them, or they could donate it to the city. Donate it to the city. We'll gladly take it. We will lease it to them. We got that resolved. But I'm telling you, we have been to the Capitol. Without Roger Thompson working nonstop on this, William Barnes, the representative for Mark Wayne Mullins, he has been very actively involved in it. And Scott Fatgatter had some input. But I'm telling you, without all of us working as a team to get this done, Quick Trip would not be here, and they would not be coming, because it was a total nightmare from the word go. I've been working on it myself, keeping it quiet since last March. And that was hounding them every week, nonstop. Any of you that were at the Shoney's grand opening heard Roger Thompson say that over and over. If I know I get a text message before 6 a.m., I can bet it's Mayor Clayson. If I get a text message after 9 p.m., I know it's her again. And that's the truth, because I go to the gym at 5 a.m., I know he's up, so I start texting him what I have on my mind.
After continued abuse of vocalizing opinions and stuff, and how the attempt to defame a community. Is there legal things that can be done?
There's been discussions, but you have to remember some of the most protected speech out there is unpopular speech. So the level of burden that's put upon you to show the intentional reckless nature to suppress that is something that's hard to do.
That's hard to prove.
But I will tell you, he is helping the case every day. But you never know when enough is enough until you test it. And when you test it, you better be pretty sure that you've got enough.
Thanks for.
Do y'all have any questions, comments about?
Thanks for being persistent.
Yeah, yes.
That's a kind word.
Observation, it's nice to, if you go to Bueno or you go to Sheldon's or some of the new things, when you see people from Walde and Morris and other places that have came to Henrietta to have dinner versus, you know, us going somewhere else.
Or you go in and don't know anybody there.
That's kind of nice.
You want to know, yeah, from the smaller communities coming, you know, Lego, we have a lot from the smaller.
Absolutely. I went into Shoney's last Thursday. It's the all-day breakfast buffet. And so we went in for dinner. We went about 5:15, and there was 10, 12 tables full, and I didn't know a single person in Shoney's.
I love to see that.
Yeah.
And then Taco Bueno, I think they told you
Taco
that
Bueno's is still doing better than any other Bueno.
Even though, to me, and I ask because I'm like, well, are they disappointed? Because sometimes I don't see the traffic, and apparently they pull up far more off the highway than any of us even imagine.
And with Quick Trip, they'll pull a whole lot more off because it's going to be a little more convenient to just loop through there and go. Mm-hmm. And there's going to be something by it. I'll tell you that.
The North Hotel, that North Hotel, they're still going to be in the hotel.
Yes. And they offered them $2.5 million to sell.
And they still go.
And they wouldn't sell it. They said, absolutely not. Because we wouldn't have to fight ODOT and we wouldn't have to do any of that. And that's originally what they came to head up for, was if we have to spend $2.5 million on this hotel, we're going to need some help. So that's why we don't know if that's what they're going to be now or not. But he refused to sell, but they were persistent. The site manager is a go-getter, and he actually has a best friend that he went to in the military with that's from Henrietta. So he was just as passionate about it as I was getting it here.